Part 1 Shreemad Bhagavatam Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Parikshith. Like Arjuna in the Bhagavad Gita, Parikshith is the principal personage who hears, and Sukha is like Shri Krishna, the teacher, who clears all the doubts of the pupil and narrates the whole of the Bhagavata Purana. Parikshith was cursed by a Brahmin boy that his life should come to an end in 7 days by the bite of a snake. When he heard of this, Parikshith immediately decided to utilize the 7 days at his disposal in an attempt to merge with the infinite. During these 7 days, the whole of the Bhagavatam was told to him by Sukha Maharishi. This was a noble example of satsang, the association of satpurushas, saints, sages and learned men in direct communion with the Lord. The soul was in association with Paramatma, the fulfillment of He and Thou are One, Tattvam Asi. Parikshith was the posthumous son of Abhimanyu, the young hero of the Mahabharata war, and the grandson of Arjuna. He was the only male member of the Pandava dynasty that was available to ascend the throne of Hastinapura after Yudhishthira. He was born after the war ended. Ashwatthama, son of Dronacharya, though a Brahmin, behaved as a mean Kshatriya. Having taken the side of Duryodhana, he wanted to please his master and so killed all the young children of the Pandavas at dead of night when they were all sleeping in their tents. Not being satisfied with this heinous crime, he wanted to destroy even the baby in the womb of Uttara, widow of Abhimanyu. But Lord Krishna saved the baby in the womb. The son that was born to Uttara later was this Parikshith. This child, out of his previous samskaras, could hear from within the womb the wailings of his mother for the loss of her husband, a young widow without any help. And when the weapon of Ashwatthama began to torture him, he began pray to the Lord to bestow all mercy on him. The Lord appeared to the child within the womb of the size of a little finger, blessed him and disappeared. That child after birth that could judge, the Lord who gave him darshan in the womb was no other than the omnipresent Lord himself. He became an ardent bhakta even from his birth. He was able to discriminate the Lord whether within or without. The Lord of the universe, and so he was called Parikshith. Parikshith was duly educated in every branch of art and was enthroned before the Pandavas decided to make their last journey towards Kailash. He reigned over the country as the personification of the Lord himself with perfectness. He was very righteous and acted up to the Dharma Shastras. He was a man without a flaw, a perfect man and an ideal king. He was greatly loved by his subjects. One day he went out to the forest for a hunt, struggled hard and was exhausted. In the forest, his followers could not follow him. He felt extremely thirsty. He could not get water anywhere. He saw a kutir nearby. He went there and asked the Brahmin that was sitting there for water. But the Brahmin could not hear his words because he was fully merged in meditation and his senses were all withdrawn. The king was hurt by the disrespect that was shown towards him by the Brahmin. He could not swallow it. He wanted to teach a lesson to the Brahmin. He saw a dead snake nearby. He took it up with the end of his bow and placed it round the neck of the Brahmin and went away. That is, he came down from his state of a perfect king and identified himself with the thirst and anger and acted in that level. His action could not have satisfied his thirst for water, but he went away to his palace. The Brahmin, who was known as Samika Mahamuni, was in his samadhi, undisturbed. But his young son, Shringi, who was playing about nearby, came there a little later and saw the snake over his father's body and began to cry. Somebody told him that the king had done so. The boy got angry and immediately cursed the king that he would be bitten by a snake and die in 7 days. Meanwhile, due to the commotion, the Brahmin came to his wakeful state and inquired about the snake and the wailing of his son. He came to know of the visit of the king and felt gravely apologetic for the lapse in not giving due respect to the king. He condemned the action of his son. A great crime had been committed against a very noble king, a righteous king, to die in 7 days. What a great calamity for the country! But he could not retrieve it. He immediately sent word to the king of the sad consequences and the impending danger and alerted him. That was all he could do. By himself, he felt that he did not offend or deserved any punishment. He was by himself beyond all actions, only a sakshi. As soon as the king heard of his impending danger, without a moment's hesitation or delay, he handed over charge of his kingdom to his son Janamejaya. He left his wife, family, palace, kingdom, kith and kin, and reached the banks of the sacred Ganges, found a convenient seat and sat down. In a flash, as if by wireless, many sages, saints, Satpurushas assembled where he sat. The king felt delighted on seeing them all. He narrated his mistake and the consequences and the danger that awaited him. He prostrated before them, begged of them to show the way for liberation, the way to avoid a rebirth. Before he could finish his self-humiliating story and humble request, there appeared on the scene sage Sukha. He was otherwise called Sukha Brahma, an Avadhuta, a youth of 16 who never cared to cover his body, who saw the Lord everywhere. He was always living in the Lord. In all the physical, mental and intellectual levels, he could feel nothing other than Brahman. He would not stay in any one place for more time than that required to milk a cow. If he felt hungry and at that time if he chanced to see somebody milking a cow, he would stop there, and if he is offered some milk, he would drink the same. Otherwise, he would just pass on as if nothing had happened. He would not ask anything. He heard the story of Parikshith in full, pitied him and consoled him that 7 days was more than the time needed for getting liberation. He initiated him into Brahma Vidya. He found the king to be a fit adhikari for it. So Parikshit knew that it was the body that would die in 7 days, that he was eternal, and so cheerfully went on questioning and hearing of the place of the Lord. Sage Sukha began to narrate one leela after another of the Lord, night and day without a break. For 7 days, the sages and the king and all the great people sitting around heard the stories and forgot all about their physical, mental or intellectual needs. Yavanartha udapane sarvataha samplutodake tavan sarveshu vedeshu brahmanasya vijanataha. When after 6 days, Sukha took leave of the king. The king was free from all anxieties. He was rather actually ready to give a hearty welcome to Lord Death. A Brahmin came forward and offered a lime fruit to the king. The king received it with reverence and pressed it to his eyes. A tiny insect came out of the lime and grew out to be a terrible serpent and bit the king. The body became ashes in a moment. This snake was called Takshaka, the most venomous serpent. He had heard of the curse of the Brahmin boy and undertook to execute it himself. On his way to the king, he met a Brahmin Kashyapa who was capable of neutralizing the poison of any snake. Takshaka bowed to him, gave him great presents and requested him not to come near the king lest his mission should fail. Then he went to the king in the form of a Brahmin and presented the lime wherein he was himself hiding as an insect. Pramodo Dhimatamapi. Even learned people are apt to slip. But their greatness lies in the fact that they rise higher after the apparent fall. A ball of soft mud, when thrown on the ground, lies flat, never more rises. But a rubber ball dashed against the ground touches the feet of the Mother Earth and immediately rises high up into the sky. There is a purpose behind the apparent fall of great men. It is always for Loka Kalyan. Out of the grave of Parikshith, as it were, grew the eternal Bhagavata, Kalpataru, to bless mankind for eternity.